Welcome to Uncomplicated. I've been on many cycling holidays, whether with friends or on my own. I'm always up for a good adventure. Ride with me and see what I get up to today.
Well, thank God, riding weather is back, and I am in the planning stages for my next trip. Every good trip starts with a lot of planning, okay? And it's mainly because I want, even if I only go for 3 or 4 days, to be this the best adventure ever. So I've got some books that I usually use, for the UK at least, to rely on in terms of telling me good routes and areas to go that are cycle friendly and so on and so forth. So I've got this book called Epic Bike Rides of the World. And there literally is every part of the world in here for epic bike rides and great holidays. England is part of the world. So what I found in one of the sections is the coast-to-coast rides. So the original one they were talking about is the From C2C, which is the Whitehaven to Sunderland ride. I don't want to do this, it's quite long. It does say how long it is somewhere. 230 kilometers, which isn't all that long, but it would take me longer than 3 or 4 days, especially since I haven't really ridden since November. You know, my dad's funeral and then the operation on my hand basically stopped me from using a bike. So now I went on to the next section of it, which says more like this coast to coast ride, and then I found the Devon coast to coast ride, which is only 161 kilometers long. I might make this a little longer because I'm gonna go the scenic route. So this is what I started out with, and then I checked in this little book called Wild Cycling, and then I found something called the Dartmoor Snapshot, which is en route basically to where I'm going, because it goes past Oakhampton. Those in this book, they give you circuits, basically circuits round, but because I go from one point to another, I could take in some of that circuit on my way to another place, for example. So yeah, this is something I'm definitely looking into for the Devon C2C. But here is my Bible. So I'm going by the traffic-free cycle rides, 150 great days out. It's from Sustrans, which is the cycling organization or charity or whatever we want to call them, in the UK, called Join the Movement, Sustrans. I've made little markers in this book where I've been, right? And the other ones I haven't marked yet. But my plan is to actually mark every single one of these pages. And I've gotten to the Dartmoor section, or the section I need. So there's one that goes to Plymouth, which would be my end point of the journey, for example. And then there is, again, the Oakhampton comes up here, which was in the other one, with a lovely route there as well. So I don't know how many of these I can take in. I'm going to prioritize this so I can, you know, mark the pages and get through the book eventually. But yeah, I'll see how I get on.
to go. It is really early in the morning. Devon, coast to coast, made our start. St Pancras first, and then take the bike from St Pancras to Paddington Station. I hope to see you there, and from there I'm going west.
I made it to St Pancras, and now I just have to find my way to Paddington. Apparently it takes about 20 minutes to ride, but I have a bit less than an hour, so hopefully I should get there.
Well, I made it to Paddington Station in time, so I've got about 10-15 minutes to maybe find a bear and where I have to go. So yeah, that's where I'm going now.
Train?
Yeah, I to Barnstable.
Is this reserved?
No.
I don't think you can. It's bank holiday and you can see the number of people. If you can do it now before the train leaves, you've got 8 minutes. GWR
book bike. Come on! Register! Oh my god, what is going on? No bookings, help, get inspired, season ticket, compensation, e-vouchers, what? It's taking hours. Come on. What? No costs associated. Continue.
If you come this way, if there's a space I give you. But if you must reserve your bike.
Yeah, sure.
If you come back before Monday, make sure you reserve your
room. I will do, thank you.
1 second, please, 1 second.
Yeah. I need to reverse, sorry. Oh, yeah. Of course. There's more over here, by the way. Just nobody used it, yeah? Yeah, they should be fine. Actually, if something's on top, it'll keep it in place. Bit over an hour before I get there, and it'll be midday.
So I arrived in Barnstable. Oh, it was such a long journey. I'm really tired. It's also really quite cold here in comparison to further up and inland, which isn't all that surprising. But first impression of Barnstable, it's kind of cute. I'm not staying here long. I'm actually going along the river.
Officially on the Tucker Trail, going towards Brownton. It's not warm, it's cloudy, but it's not super cold, it's not raining, so I'm not complaining, I'm just saying. Ooh, gate, hang on. So I'd say the cycling holiday has officially started. I'm officially riding. It's a really nice trail actually. I'm almost sure I'm not coming back this way, and I'll take a different way on the Tucker Trail tomorrow. But having said that, this is part of the cycle route number 27, which is probably going to guide me all the way along from north to south. It's cycle route 27. And I'm actually quite looking forward to it, because as far as I can see, I've hardly got any traffic, and most of it will probably look like this result. First stop after coming to Barnstable, I'm now somewhere near Ashford. I went across that river that leads to the sea, and then along. And now I'm at a garden centre plus farm shop. Guess what I'm buying? I'm going to try and find some local cheese to take, and I'll update you after. Leave it on the counter, I'll be just checking some more out, thank you. Yeah, let's have a small slither of that, so I can try that. Yeah. Yeah, that sounds good.
Well, that's quite small. Is that okay?
Go with that. It's not like I won't eat it. It says gluten-free.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, as a celiac, it's really difficult to then find anything that you can eat with your cheese. I don't mind eating cheese by itself, don't get me wrong. I do that. That's lovely, thanks very much. Stay in. No, I don't. I need to put it on a bike. I don't know what to do with a box after that. Thanks very much. And I'll figure it out from here. Thanks. See you later. So for some reason, since I arrived in Barnstable, now I'm a little bit outside of Barnstable, they have these old telephone boxes still everywhere. It's kind of cute to see, because I miss them. I used to have one of those on my road when I lived in London. That is over 20 years ago. And ever since then, they kind of, well, disappeared, right?
And the next challenge is to find new sunglasses. I'll keep you updated on that. Tomorrow's at least a normal working day. Today is a bank holiday.
I think it's safe to say everybody and their dog is out. That's why usually I go away. It is a bank holiday weekend. I arrived at Saunton Sands. I bought myself new sunglasses in the souvenir shop, which I needed desperately because the other ones were too scratched. I don't think I'm a massive fan of salt and sand because, well, it's a bit of a circus here, too many people, and I came down a really steep hill and now I'm going to have to go up a really steep hill to get past these buildings again. I was also going to sit here for some lunch, but I don't think I'm going to enjoy that one bit, so I'm off again. I'm still surrounded by surfers in that direction.
It's quite rocky in the other end.
The little peninsula there, that's my halfway point. I'm not way over halfway through the day, so that is interesting. It's very touristy, very, very touristy. I didn't expect that in the slightest, not the surfers or anything. But I can see the surf, so I understand why. And I see all of the big German car brands here, the Teslas driving around, the houses are big, there's a lot of designer clothing going on. I think I need to get out of here, I don't fit in. Let's talk. I bought some olives and something to put cheese on, crackers and some whole grain bread. I've got some brie, which is a local brie. She told me the name, but it's not on here, so I can't remember now. Then I have the Tor Valley Tasty Cheddar Cheese, which is also from Devon. It looks like this. A little salty, slightly bitter. I can live with that. Right. For those of you who followed along, I have a knife now. I mean, a proper knife to open stuff with, cut cheese with. Because this comes from my dad's house. So much better than my blunt knife that I used before. Let's try this. This is the Tor Valley local flavor for Chor Cheddar. Right home about. But hey, those are the two cheeses of the day. I better get going, have finished my lunch so I can actually get back to the hotel, which is in a whole different area. And over there, the clouds are dangerously low. At this point, I don't even care anymore whether I make it before it gets dark or not. It probably won't make it. It's a long way away, it feels. And I'm on gravel roads or paths, gravel paths that lead to nowhere first before they go somewhere. So yeah, I don't know how long it's going to take me. And at this point, I'm looking at the return going up these, and then hopefully a different way back down.
Oh, so I just walked this up. That's so hard. So very hard. But up here, so there's a Sanford Coast Path again. That thing's called a Baggy Point, which is awesome, was worth it. And then come here, and there's this wall running along the top that I'm sort of going to follow now. And I'm also kind of in a cloud now. So weather's definitely turned to November, but I'm warm enough, so it's not too bad. Unrealistic that I'm thinking I might get away with it without stepping in blue. Yeah, it's slow going. I think I have to find a road and cut this beautiful coastal path short. Although I quite like the sheep, some really sound very funny. I can see a road!
Well, I say I can see something driving.
So I'm gonna head there and hope I find a quick way, quickish way, the quickest way to Ilfracombe. Well, good evening by now. So I diverted off the path, I'm on the road, and I have been for what seems hours now, it's at least 2 hours now anyway. And I'm not kidding, it's only uphill. I mean, I've not been out of the small gears once. If there is a slight bit of downhill, you're still pedaling. That's only 10 seconds. Oh my word, this is hard work. I know I haven't done this in ages. November last time I went been on an ordinary bike, and you can tell. My phone is running out of battery. So I'm really, really concerned at this point that it will last until I'm there, because I don't really know anything about the hotel. So wish me luck at this point, seriously. This place is stunning. My room is literally so awesome. My bike's downstairs, somewhere in the kitchen, happy. And the lady who owns the B&B is making me breakfast. Well, breakfast to go, lunch, in fact, because I don't really like breakfast. But she's just amazing. She found a gluten-free batter mix and everything, so I can't really wait for the morning now.